Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about chronic pancreatitis. Chronic pancreatitis is an inflammation of the pancreas that does not heal or improve, gets worse over time, and leads to permanent damage. The pancreas is an organ located behind the stomach and produces chemicals called enzymes needed to digest food. It also produces hormones like glucagon and insulin. When inflammation and scarring of the pancreas occurs, the organ no longer can make the right amount of these enzymes. As a result, you are unable to digest food and other important functions. Damage to the pancreas can lead to insulin loss and thus diabetes. This condition is most often caused by chronic alcohol consumption and thus chronic pancreatitis. But sometimes the cause is not known. Other conditions that have been linked to chronic pancreatitis include autoimmune problems, which is when the immune system attacks your own body. Also, blockage of the pancreatic duct or the common bile duct, the tubes that drain enzymes from the pancreas. Complications of cystic fibrosis, high levels of fat called triglycerides in the blood or hypertriglyceridemia, hyperparathyroidism, use of certain medications like estrogens, corticosteroids, thiazide diuretics, and azathioprine. Chronic pancreatitis occurs most often in men than in women and usually develops between the ages of 30 and 40 years. Symptoms of chronic pancreatitis include abdominal pain, greatest in the upper part of the abdomen, and may last from hours to days. Eventually, it can become continuous, may get worse after eating or drinking, and may get worse after drinking alcohol. It may also radiate all the way through the back. It can cause digestive problems, chronic weight loss, even when eating habits and amounts are normal. Also diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, fatty or oily stools, pale or clay-colored stools. The symptoms may become more frequent as the condition becomes worse. The symptoms may mimic pancreatic cancer. Sitting up or leaning forward sometimes relieve the pain of pancreatitis. Signs and tests. Tests for pancreatitis include fecal fat test, serum amylase, serum IgG4 for diagnosing autoimmune pancreatitis, serum lipase, serum trypsinogen, and calcium deposits of the pancreas or changes to the ducts of the pancreas may be seen on abdominal CT scan, on abdominal ultrasound, on an endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography or ERCP. Endoscopic ultrasound can also show some changes. MRCP, which is magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography, also an exploratory laparotomy or surgery may be done to confirm the diagnosis, but this is usually done for acute pancreatitis. What is the treatment? People with severe pain who are losing weight may need to stay in the hospital for pain medication, fluids given through a vein or IV, stopping food or fluid by mouth to limit the activity of the pancreas, and slowly start oral diet again. Inserting a tube through the nose to the mouth to remove the contents of the stomach or nasogastric suctioning may sometimes be done. This is usually done for 1 to 2 days, but as long as 1 to 2 weeks. Eating the right diet is important for people with chronic pancreatitis. A nutritionist will be needed to help educate you about the right diet. Make sure you drink plenty of fluids. Eating a low-fat diet. Eating small, frequent meals, which helps reduce digestive symptoms. Getting enough vitamins and calcium in the diet or as extra supplements. Limit your caffeine intake. The doctor may prescribe pancreatic enzymes, which you must take with every meal. The enzymes will help you digest food better and gain weight. Avoid smoking or drinking alcoholic beverage, even if your pancreatitis is mild. Other treatments may involve pain medicines or a surgical nerve block to relieve the pain. Taking insulin to control your sugar or glucose levels. Surgery may be recommended if a blockage is found. In severe cases, part or the whole pancreas may be removed. Prognosis. This is a serious disease that may lead to disability and even death. You can reduce the risk by not drinking alcohol. Complications include ascites, which is fluid accumulation within your abdomen, a blockage or obstruction of the small intestines or bile ducts, a blood clot in the vein of the spleen, fluid collections in the pancreas or pancreatic pseudocysts that may become infected. poor functioning of the pancreas is also one of the complications. Diabetes, fat or other nutrient malabsorption, vitamin malabsorption, most often fat-soluble vitamins like A, D, E, or vitamin K. Call your healthcare provider to follow up, and call them specifically if you're developing symptoms of acute pancreatitis on top of your chronic disease. If you have pancreatitis and your symptoms get worse or do not improve with treatment. Prevention of the disease. Determining the cause of the acute pancreatitis and treating it quickly will help prevent chronic pancreatitis. Not drinking alcohol reduces the risk of this condition. If you have persistent nausea or vomiting, increasing pain, high fever, you're dehydrated, your abdomen is becoming distended or bloated, you must come back to the emergency department for reevaluation. Remember, these are educational videos and should never replace the attention or care from a medical provider. Thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to click I like the video and to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.